hell of a beta.
Hello everyone, I'm Zach and welcome back to another HitFilm tutorial. Inspired by Spider-Man No Way Home, we'll be looking at how to turn yourself into Doc Ock using HitFilm and Blender. This project can be created 100% for free using HitFilm Express, but I'll be using HitFilm Pro to add some extra details. I've already created the 3D model arms in Blender, which you can find in the video description. Today I'll be focusing on how to add those robot arms to your video, but let us know if you'd like to see a tutorial covering the 3D modeling and rigging process. I'd recommend getting familiar with Blender before following along, so be sure to check out the other Blender videos on this channel linked in the description. To start off this effect, we need a video clip of our actor with some tracking markers. These green tape markers will allow us to track the motion so the robot arms stick to the actor. We decided to film in front of green screen so we could change the background in HitFilm. Pay attention to the lighting while filming, as we'll need to replicate it in Blender later on. To work with our footage in Blender, we should first convert it to an image sequence. Load the video into HitFilm, then export it as a PNG sequence. With our footage filmed and converted to an image sequence, we can hop over to Blender to start tracking. The type of track you'll need depends on your footage. If your actor is stationary and not rotating very much like in this shot, you can get away with a 2D point track. If they are rotating like in this shot, you will need to do a 3D object track. I'll focus on the easiest shot for now. Start by creating a new VFX project, then load in your image sequence. Adjust the project resolution and frame rate to match your footage. Then click Set Scene Frames to make the project the right length. Click the Prefetch button so we can play the footage smoothly. I found that the default tracking settings worked well for this shot, so we can just Ctrl-click to add a tracker. Press E to track, then hit Ctrl-L to lock it. I'll add a second tracker since the two markers aren't the same distance away from the camera, meaning they move differently to each other. In the Solve tab, click Set as Background to see our footage through our 3D camera. If you know the focal length of your lens and the sensor size of your camera, now is a good time to enter those in. Select both trackers and hit Link Empty to track. I'll add a layout workspace so it's easier to work in 3D space. If we go into camera view, you can see these two points track to the movement in our video. The default camera angle doesn't really make sense compared to our video, so let's adjust it so the 3D grid floor lines up with the floor in the video. I'll lock the camera to view and move around to roughly the right spot. Then I'll adjust the camera's location and rotation settings. Make sure to unlock the camera from our view so we don't accidentally move it. Now that our Blender scene is set up and tracked, we can move on to the fun part, adding the robot arms. The downloadable project files include this rigged 3D model of Doc Ock's arms. To bring them into your project, go to File, Append, then navigate to the Doc Ock arm files and import the arms collection. Each pair of arms are parented to a base, so you can move them all together. Parent the base models to your tracked points and move, rotate, and scale them into place. The base model is a flat plane, but you can edit it to roughly match the back of your actor. Go into edit mode and select some vertices, then move them into place with proportional editing enabled. This gives you control over the falloff of your edits, creating a smoother result. I found the smooth and sharp settings to be the most useful. You may also want to use local transforms to make it easier to move things in the right direction. Each arm has its own armature which allows it to be animated. With an armature selected, go into Pose Mode. Here you can select different parts of the rig and move them around to control the shape of the arm. The green controller is the base of the arm. Adjust its position and rotation to place the arm correctly so it covers the tracking marker. Also make sure it isn't floating above the base. These two yellow controllers are the main controls for the arm, and you can adjust their position, rotation, and scale. The scale doesn't increase their size, but rather adjusts the curvature of the arm. You can also adjust the scale of this base controller if needed. The red controllers are for the claw. This one rotates the claw, and the other three open and close the claw. You can select just one controller at a time like this, or you can select all three and control them like this. Start by adjusting the rig to create your initial pose. then activate keyframing for each controller's properties. You can click this button to enable automatic keyframes, which will insert a keyframe every time you make a change. Now you are free to go through the length of the shot, animating the arm to move however you want. Once you are happy with this arm's animation, go back into object mode, select a different armature, go back into pose mode, and repeat the process to animate the next arm. For this arm, I want the claw to be resting on the ground, so it shouldn't move along with the tracking. To detach it from the track, click this button on the child of constraint for the end arm controller. This keeps its current position, but makes it no longer parented to the base. If you had a keyframe set, make sure to replace it to keep the new location. To make things easier, I'd recommend making sure no arms go behind your actor. Otherwise, you'd have to render each arm separately and either manually rotoscope them or use the green-screened actor as a mat. Your animation may play back slowly in the viewer. You can improve playback performance by hiding the arm segments, leaving camera view, and hiding all the other arms. Our Doc Ock arms are now moving around and looking cool, but let's make them look more realistic with some lighting. An easy way to create realistic lighting is to use an HDRI. You can find a variety of free HDRIs on polyhaven.com. Try to choose one that best matches the look and lighting of your video footage. Since our clip was shot on a green screen, I chose one that generally matched the background I'd be adding in later. To add the HDRI to your scene, go to the World Properties, set the color to Environment Texture, and open your HDRI. Enable Material Preview, then enable Scene World from this drop-down menu. The Doc Ock arm models come with materials already set up, so we can now see our HDRI reflected on the metal. If you want to match your footage even closer, you can add additional light objects to replicate the practical lighting. Make sure to disable automatic keyframing so you don't accidentally animate your lights and other objects. Switch over to the Cycles render engine. This will take a lot longer to render, but produces much more realistic results. If you have a fast graphics card, you may want to render with that instead of your CPU. Set the film to transparent so it will render with a transparent background, and also enable motion blur. Go into rendered view to see a lower quality preview, or go to render, render image to see the current frame in full quality. I want this claw to cast a shadow on the floor, so I'll add a new plane object, scale it up, and in the object properties I'll enable shadow catcher. Adjust the material of the base plane objects to match the color of your actor's clothing. We don't want to see these objects directly, but they should still affect the metal arms. Set the base collection to indirect only, then set it to holdout. Now it will affect the lighting and reflections of the metal arms without being seen, and it will cut out of the arms if they are behind. The top of this arm is currently being cut off in the render. To fix this, we first need to duplicate our camera. Our tracking data is linked to our original camera, so we don't want to change that one. I'll hide the other camera from view. Make the duplicate the active camera by selecting it and hitting Ctrl Numpad 0. We can now increase the resolution of our project. I'll multiply both values by 1.25. Set the background images to fit instead of stretch, and scale them down so they line up again. In this case, I'll divide by 1.25. We also need to divide the render camera's focal length by that same value. When you are happy with how everything is looking, go to the output properties and create a folder for your rendered image sequence. Make sure the file format is PNG and the color is RGBA. Then go to render, render animation. Our CG render looks pretty cool on its own. But let's integrate it into our video. The downloadable project files include this footage of Ollie with the green screen already removed. The background was created using a single frame of a stock video clip, along with an additional stock photo to add some clouds. This sky replacement doesn't look the greatest, but I knew I would add a lens blur effect which would hide any imperfections. Import the image sequence we rendered out of Blender and drag it onto the timeline above our footage. Use a curves effect to adjust the brightness, contrast, and color of the CG render. Add a very subtle blur effect to match the sharpness of the video. Then add a grain effect to match the noisy footage. You can add a little bit of bloom to the highlights by using glow or super glow effects. To better blend the actor and robot arms with the green screen background, I made them into their own comp, then added color correction and light wrap effects. Our CG render is being cut off at the top again, so make sure to increase the height of the composite. The green screen key didn't retain Ollie's shadow, but we can add it back in. To do this, I used another copy of the footage and masked out just the shadow area. I then used a luminance key to remove the brighter areas, leaving the shadow. A crushed blacks and whites alpha effect was used to increase the shadow opacity. I then colored the shadow with a fill color effect and added some blur. We can now reposition Doc Ock wherever we want in the final comp. Once your robot arms and green screen background are all matching nicely, you can add some additional effects to tie everything together. In my final shot, I used a custom light flare to represent the sun, and added a vignette to darken the corners. I created a custom color grid using curves and hue saturation. Then used shake effects to add some more motion to the shot. A radial blur effect with a low radius setting was centered on Ollie's face. This effect was used to soften the edges, especially around the feet area, and draw attention towards the center of the frame. I finished off the composite with some chromatic aberration and lens dirt. And that's how you can create your own Doc Ock arm VFX. Be sure to check out our other Marvel superhero tutorials. Leave a comment and hit the like button if you learned something new. Remember to subscribe for more tutorials like this. See you next time!